continue, and it's an we start. The introduction part is Adhitvat or Vatananatma Jivadi, which is called as Ekayam also, and symptoms in it is Mukha Vakrata, deviation of a face, and the Ekakshi Nimilana is means the blinking of a single eye. And next symptom is Ashrushrava. The Ashrushrava means the lacrimal duct will be so much activated here, and the Ashrushrava means the watery discharge from an eye will be there. Lalata Vakrata, Bru or the Lalata Bhaga, Vakrata over the single side will be there. Ruja in the Jaturdhur Pradesha, heaviness in the forehead place, in the eyeball, in the face, in the cheek region, half part of an, the tongue, a single side of a face will be very much, the sensation will be less, and it will be loss of sensation will be there at single side. And Vaksanga, difficulty in speech will be there. Vaksanga means a patient can't speak out the words or something, so he can't speak. And Hasita Vakrata, while clinically a patient looks like a Vakrata on the smile, Hasita Vakrata will be there. With the disfigurement of uncertainly faces over the single lateral side, the Ardhitvat will be affected, which is what I have taken with a special reference to a Bell's palsy correlated. And Ardhitvata symptoms are very much correlated with an Bell's palsy. That's what which I have been explained, with asymmetrical face, even at rest also, and efforts to close an eye merely causes an eyeball to roll up is known as Bell's phenomenon. And incidence rate of 5 of 23 lakh per year, about 1 in 60 to 70 people in overall lifetime will be seen. And next is, after an introduction, a small figure I am showing you on the screen, there is an inability to close the eyelid and facial nerve which is affected in a certainly local place. And drooping of a mouth will be a peculiar, moreover, main symptom seen. And next is, Ardhitvata is one among the Vatananatma Jivadi, which is also called as an Ekayama, Mukavakrata, Ekakshinimilna, Ashrushrava, Lalatavakrata, Rujaj at Jaturdha Pradesha, Vaksanga, Hasita Vakrata are the symptoms correlated with Bell's palsy. Incidence rate is 23 per 1 lakh per year. Also, more prevalent known cases in cases of hypertension and diabetic. In Ayurvedic classics, hello.
Yes, sir.
Hello. Is it audible now?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. It is audible. Please continue.
Through the Nasya Karma, which I have been taken as a choice of treatment here in Ardhitvata, Ekangvaris as an its own effect in the Ardhitvata as Shamanoshali. And Ekangvaris is an herbal mineral medicine with nanoparticles of basmas, which acts on the CNS, central nervous system. So clinically study is taken, and Nasya Karma with Vishnu Taila and Ekangvaris as a Shamanoshadi in Ardhitvata Chikitsa with special reference to Bell's palsy is a today topic which have been taken. And next is a Bell's palsy. It's a very commonest which is correlated. It's commonest type of facial palsy. It is a major cause acute facial nerve paralysis, where the edematous swelling in the facial nerve will be there, which affects totally half of the face due to element lesion, lower motor nerve lesion. Here the palsy due to inflammation of a facial nerve. Inflammation prevents the nerve from sending the correct signals to brain and facial muscles. And difference between a facial muscle and Bell's palsy is, cause the facial palsy means cause can be known due to it may be due to infection, it may be due to trauma, it may be due to tumor, and maybe an edema. cause lasts for a year together in facial palsy. Need and surgical treatment, surgical procedure in facial palsy. Site of affection depends on the UNM and LMN lesions. Both the upper and lower motor nerve defects will be there. In case of an Bell's palsy, it is idiopathic, may be developed suddenly, temporary cure within 3 months, and 90% of the cases with the treatment. Hello, sir.
Yes, sir.
Hello. Slide, is it visible slide?
Sir, students are complaining that slide is not visible. I request you to share it again, sir.
Yes, I will share it. Now, sir?
Yes, it is visible, sir.
Yes, sir, it is visible.
It's visible now? Okay. Now, is it visible now?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir, yes.
If there is something, you tell me, because I will be going on explaining the things. I am concentrating more on the subjects part. If the voice is not clear or the slide is not visible, please tell me. We will concentrate on it and I will continue the next session. The facial palsy and Bell's palsy has got a difference with them. So you are seeing, you are looking on the screen. It is the Bell's palsy, it is idiopathic, maybe developed suddenly. But it is a temporary, permanent cure will be there within 3 months without a treatment, surgery, regions, facial function. It is mainly due to lower motor lesions, half a side of the facial totally deformed. And next is the difference between UMN and the LMN lesions. Only 2/3 of the facial muscles are affected in upper motor nerve. Mid face is paralyzed. Eyebrow can be moved normally in upper motor nerve. In lower motor nerve, the totally half side of the face is affected. Mid face is only paralyzed. Eyebrow can't move normally in the lower motor nerve, which happens in the Bell's palsy. And next is the main thing we have been seen within the affected part and the lesions are the affected, whatever the clinical features we have studied now. Now I am going to enter the review of literature where the classical references are the present in our references in our literature. Ardhitvata is nothing but Mukhavakrata. Ardhitvata is explained in an Ekayama by Ashtanga Hridaya. Vatananatmaja Vyadhi and Vatahara Vihara, biting hard things due to, these are all the Nidanas, which Ati Hasana and the Uchya Bhashana are the Megavaroda and Vegadharana, etc. are the leading causes, leading Nidanas for it. Vepatu and the Charma Suptata is a Puru Rupa. Along with the Mukardha Vakrata, Vaksanga, Lalasrava and the Jaturdva Ruja, etc. are the Lakshanas seen in an Ardhitvat. Ardhitvat classified depending on the doshas as with the types Vataja, Pittaja and Kafaja. Nasya Murtitaira is the Chikitsa Sutra or the line of treatment in Ardhitvat as explained. And next, I don't take much more time, which have been explained before this, the Shirasa Bhara Harana Dadi Hasya Prabhashanat. That's what they have been explained. The carrying the heavy loads on the head, excessive laughing, speaking, causing the exertion to face, sneezing, bending very stiff bows, use irregular pillows with them while sleeping, chewing very hard materials and affected to a cold, and Nidana causes which leads to an vishishan of an Vata getting localized and upper parts of the body that leads to an Ardhitvat. And next is, it's an Ardhitvat facial according to the Acharya Charaka. It has been explained. Ardhe tasmin mukharde va kevale syat ardhitam. It has been explained. Ati vradha sharirardhamekam vayu prapadyate. It has been explained. A single part or the single side of a face is affected. Tasmin sankocha सर्दे मुखम जिवाम करोति च वक्री करोति नासा गुरु ललाट ललाट अक्षि हनुस तथा मीन्स दि नासा भाग गुरु भाग ललाट भाग अक्षि भाग अनुग्रीवा भाग इज अफेक्टेड इन अर्थित्वात. These are all the explanations given in Ardhitva, explanation given in Acharya Charaka Samhita. And next is, according to the Shushruta reference, the Shushruta Samhita explains about the Ardhayitva Anilo, Vaktram Ardhitam. It has been explained. Garbini, Garbini Sutika Bala, Bala Vraddakshino Vasrakshayi. In case of in Garbinis, in Sutikas, in Bala, in all the ages, in all the age groups, where the Nidana Parivarjana is there, where the Nidana is predominant, where the causes of and the Nidana has been explained, in all the cases, where in all the ages, with irrespective of age and sex, it is affected. And next is the Chikitsa Sutra. The Chikitsa Sutra here is the अर्दिताय नावनम मूर्ति तैला तर्पणमेवच नाडीस्वेद उपनाह उपनाह अनुपेक्षितहि अर्दिता इज मेन चिकित्सा सूत्र एक्सप्लेन्ड इज नावननस्य. हियर द नस्य इज अ लाइन ऑफ ट्रीटमेंट विद द मूर्ति तैला. द नस्य इज अ लाइन ऑफ ट्रीटमेंट एक्सप्लेन्ड अकॉर्डिंग टू द आचार्य सुश्रुता एंड द आचार्य चरक. And next is the composition of an Vishnu Taila which I have been selected. Here I am going to tell. All the Vata Shamaka Dravyas, like Kalka Dravyas used in the preparation of an Vishnu Taila is the Shalipani, Prashnapani, Bala, Shatavari, Eranda, Brahati, Kantakari, Karanja, Atibala, Sahachara. Sahachara is a main drug. Shalipani, Prashnapani, Bala. These are all the Vata Shamaka Dravyas. The moolas of all these Dravyas taken with the Sneha Dravya, a Tilataila, and the Dravya Dravya with the Godukta, according to the classical preparation of a Taila preparation, Vishnu Taila is prepared. It's a reference of a Vaishya Ratnavadi, the Taila is prepared. Of course, I don't much concentrate on the preparation of Taila, it is another other thing. Which comes in our Rashastra part, the composition of an all these drugs which are Vata Shamaka Dravyas, which is used to prepare the Vishnu Taila. And next is the Nasya figure, as I have shown, the six drops are the classical dosage which have been used in all the age groups which have been practiced in my classical study. And next is it's an ekangvirus drug. It's an herbo mineral drug which has been explained in the classics, which is constituent, which is a classical reference here I've been showing. And next is the drug review of an ekangvirus and method of preparation. The Shuddha Parada, Shuddha Gandaka, it's an Kajali, Kanta Loha, and the Basmas of an Vanga Basma and the Loha Basma are there. These are all the herbo mineral drugs which are used at 250 mg of an ekangvirus in a TID dosage. Its dosage with a classical reference of 1 to 2 ratti pramana, it has been given, but I am using the 250 mg TID, means 750 mg of a drug dosage which ekangvirus I am using in my classical study. And next is the constituent of an mainly the ekangvirus is Shuddha Gandaka, Shuddha Parada, and Shuddha Kanta Loha Basma, Vanga Basma, Naga Basma, and the Tamra Basma, Abraka Basmas, Trikshna Loha Basmas, and Nagara means the Shunti, Maricha, Pimpali. Each Dravya are taken Samabhaga and Bhavana Dravya is done with the three times with each Dravya. And Bhavana Dravyas, Rifalo Trikato, and Nirkundi, Chitrakashi, Grupushta. You may see the Varshamaka and Rasayana Dravyas, which are there here, which affects on the predominance of an Vata, means in Ardhitvata. And methods, merits of Rasaushadhi using in the choose, why I have chosen the Ekangvirus here? In name itself explains, ekanga viraras means which acts on the ekanga, which acts on the Bell's palsy, which acts on the single sided of an the paralytic stroke, which has been a Bell's palsy paralyzed condition in the single sided of an body in phase. Rasaushadhis mainly act as an vadinashanam, which acts a vadinashanam character, which has an vadinashanam curative act. Curative act is there, which is also called as an the avikara vyapatam, means relieves complication. Na ati glanikarakam, least complication. The gandavarna rasopetam means acceptable color, order and taste. Bahudosha haranam means broad spectrum of an activity. Sukham, which is easier to administer and which is faster assimilation, which disintegrates in the human body or intestine very easily. The sukhaswadanam, palatable taste. Priranam means pleasant and agreeable. The alpamatram, minute and the minimal doses. Quick action, mahavegam, which has an the quick action. And next I am going to, with all these explanations, with all these, whichever drugs I am going to use, the Vishnu Taila Nasya as for Mukabhyanga and the Nasya and the Ekangulas as an oral medicine, whichever I am using in my clinical study, with all these aspects I am going to enter the case studies. Which are all the cases, how it is going to act, how these clinical symptoms are there. Mainly the Roga Pariksha comes here. Clinical conditions. A patient comes to you. All the vitals are investigations are taken. For an example, the diabetics, ECG, or the routine investigations are done. The Dashavida Pariksha, or the the Chaturvida, or the Shadvida Pariksha, Darshana, Sparshana Pariksha, all these done. Or the phase, the deviation of a phase on looking on Darshana itself, the deviation of the face of a patient is seen. There will be a one-sided, single-sided deviation of a face is seen. Blinking of a single eye is seen. I will show you in the figure in forthcoming slides. Single-sided deviation of a face is seen. Ekakshi nimilana means one akshi, means one netra. One eye will be, only single eye will be blinking. And Shiro Gauravata are the Lalata Vakrata is seen. Lalata Vakrata is seen. And Vak Sangha will be there. These are all the symptoms, clinical symptoms mainly seen in the Rogi Pariksha. And next, these are all the cases of my college OPDs which have been taken a history and the case is treated with the neat treatments and maintained. I have taken here only the two cases which I am going to explain in detail with a systemic manner. These are all the one of the cases, a boy within 16 years who has been affected, who came to my hospital at evening 7 o'clock. It was a very cold season, which on that day when he came, the Mukavakra, and another one is a female, female within 57 years. She is also came within so and so symptoms. When we asked the patient to came to hospital and asked them to smile or deviate, the deviation over the face is seen. She can't move the single side over the where the mukha is mainly affected. And next, after a treatment, how mukhavakrata is treated, how mukhavakrata has been before, it's a before treatment, after treatment you may see in the figure, the after treatment. When I ask the patient to smile, when I ask the patient to show their teeth, this is before treatment and this is after treatment. After 10 days Nasya and oral medicines, 250 mg Ekangulas TID, with certainly all the Rasna Sapta Kashaya and Rasna Kashaya, within that, with all the physiotherapies and with the oral medicine, Ekangulas and Vishnu Taila Nasya and Mukabhyanga, with the Shiro Bhyanga, Gala Bhyanga, with the Bhashpa Sveda, which have been done, with the 10 days treatment only, Mukavakrata is seen as you are looking in the slide. And next symptom is Bell's phenomenon. If we ask the patient to close the eyes, single eye will be closed and another, which affected part, eye will not be closed. Only a simple a bit of an eye is opened. The blackish part is not seen. You may see in the figure. And next, after a treatment, you may see the eye closed. Before a treatment, the eye is opened, left-sided eye is opened, where the affected part, and you may see the closed eyes completely, where the Bell's phenomenon is not seen. And next is the Lalata Vakrata. The Lalata Bhaga or the forehead, you may see the grooves on the single side. There is a skin folds on the forehead region. You may look in the figure. Before a treatment, a single-sided folds or the grooves are seen on the forehead. And the Lalata Vakrata, a single eyebrow is only raised. Right-sided eyebrow is only raised. The left-sided eyebrow is not raised here. It is inactive completely. And after a treatment, you may see here, both the eyebrows are raised. You may see the folds, skin folds on the forehead, both sides. In the both the cases, it's a very comparative, after 10 days, very systemic treatment we have given. And with the nurse and ekangaras, we have got a good result, you may see in the slide. And next is a figure which I am showing. You may see the case where I asked the patient to close his eyes. You may see the Bell's phenomena here. And I asked to blow the air. Next. And next is a female case. You may see the Bell's phenomena. The patient itself is telling that she had a heaviness and pain over the cheek side, where the affected part is there. The Mukha Vakrata is seen. You may see the another boy with the Bell's phenomena, where the affected part, you may see their live figure here. The Mukha Vakrata is seen. Where skin folds are the Lalata Bhaga is single-sided smoothing. When I asked the patient to blow the air, and next is the part is treatment which have been done, it has got a references within the Charaka Shushruta Samhita within Lagutraya and Brahatrayas in the Acharya Charaka Samhita and the Shushruta Samhita, which have got a good references. And conclusion is, Nasya is suitable line of management in the Ardhidvat Chikitsa. Vishnutaila Nasya is a choice of treatment which expels the vitiated doshas. You listen carefully. Nasya is a suitable line of treatment and management in Ardhidvat Chikitsa. Vishnutaila Nasya is a choice of treatment which expels vitiated doshas from shiras. These cases, Vishnutaila is taken for Snehana, Svedana and Nasya, along with the Ekangviras as a Shamana Ushadi. According to the Ayurvedic thermodynamic properties, Ekangviras has an ability to pacify the vitiated Vata doshas from Shiras. Due to its the Madhura Rasa, Snigdha Guna, Ushnavira and Madhura Vipaka Guna, it is also pacifies the vitiated Kapha dosha by Tikta, Katu, Kashaya Rasa and Lagu Guna, Ruksha Guna, Ushnavira and Katu Vipaka properties. Also, the ingredients of Bhavana Dravyas like Ekanguras, whichever have been explained, are very much effective in management of Ardhidvat, which have been concluded with these my clinical studies, with the clinical short studies. With this, I am going to end my short topic of on Ardhidvata, which is a Vata Vedi, which have been explained in my clinical study. With Vishnutaila and Ekangaras, you may try all the forthcoming doctors or the forthcoming students, you may try it, you may have a good study with them. With a good study, you may have a try in our clinical in the hospitals. Yes.
Thank you so much, sir. Thank you so much. Thank you for this informative session. I'm sure each one of us have learned a lot from this session and will definitely apply it in our practices. So let's just move on to the question answer sessions. If there is in the chat box, please put your questions in the chat box. Sir, first question is from Dr. Shubham. Sir, is Brihannase used there?
Yes, it may be used. Brihannase is used. Yes, Brihannase is used. But here the predominance of Vata will be there. Hence the we have used the Shodhana. Also, the Vishnu Taila is having the Brahmana property drugs also are also there. The Pala is there. Shatavari is there. These are all the rasa, which gives the Brahmana effect also.
Sir, please elaborate the Nasya part, whether we have to use Marsh or Prati Marsh Nasya.
The Nasya is, I will explain in simply, the thing is, a patient made the Sukshma Rachel drugs are given, the Apathakara and all for 3 to 5 days, when the patient is kept in our admission, admitted in our hospital, and next, with the nil only, the patient is given with an alpahara and taken for a procedure. The mukha banga, shirom banga, gala banga, according to the classical procedure, the abhyanga is done and bhashpa sveda with an ushna jala with an vastra, the bhashpa sveda is done. In optional cases, there is so much of an, the other svedas are also used. With that also, now here I have chosen the Bhashpa Sveda with the Nasya, 6 drops which have been used as an, in each nostril, the 6 drops of a Vishnu Taila Nasya is done, and same with the Vishnu Taila, the Abhyanga is also done. We have got the result. I want here to explain you the clinical efficacy of a Vishnu Taila. Efficacy of Vishnu Taila, which is a Vata Shamaka Taila, which is also a Rasayana, Brahmana Taila is also, Brahmana property is also its Hari. That's what the Nasya with the Vishnu Taila and Labhyanga is done. And lastly, after the Nasya, Nasya is done, and patient is made into rest for 20 to 30 minutes, and he may be with the warm and all the other procedures. Classically, whatever the Nasya diets and regimens has been explained, it is followed.
Thank you, sir. So next question is from Dr. Deepti Patel. What will the duration of Nasya?
10 days.
So next question. Yes, sir. So next question is, sir, does Nasya oil are felt in throat? Felt in throat.
It may be there. It will be there. Little bit there. There will be an effect in the throat region, where the patient is asked to wash with the warm water. A hot water is given to gargle or the clean the throat. Raise scrotum and all.
Next question is from Dr. Kiran. Other than these two, any other internal medicine given, sir?
Some of the Vata Shamaka Dravyas are given, and the kashayas like rasa saptaka and rasnadi kashaya is given, depends on the symptom and the patient presence we will be giving. But major thing is, I used the Nasya for Vishnu Taila and Ekanga Rasana, the medicine, oral medicine here.
So next question is, I have not seen Vishnu Tail available anywhere. Can you please tell where we shall get it?
Yes, myself only. I have got a pharmacy here and I have got prepared here. If you give the my number to them, and I will meet them to supply there, and I will get it be available there. You give my number to them. Let them be in contact with me.
Yes, sure, sir. So next question is from Dr. Revathi. Sir, what was the diet followed by the patient during the treatment?
Ati ruksha ahara, vatakara ahara vihara is avoided here. Vatakara ahara vihara is avoided here.
So next question is from Dr. Atre. Sir, what is if patient have ardit along with diabetes mellitus and hypertension? Treatment protocol same or what can changes is done?
Treatment protocol will be same, but the hypertension and the diabetic profile, sir, we must see that, we must look into it that the hypertension and diabetic profile should be under control.
So next question is it helpful in vertigo? Because is inner ear balance affected by wrong posture in yoga?
Maybe, sir. Maybe because it's an Vatshyamakatravyas, there are so much of an Vatshyamakatravyas are present in the Vishnu Taila and the Ekangaras. It may be helpful. In all the Pakshagata cases also, in all the some of the Arya cases, in Sandhivata and Amavata cases also, we used to preferably use the Vishnu Taila in day-to-day practice, which I am practicing.
So next question is, before breakfast, how can we apply Snehan? Please elaborate in step by step.
Before breakfast, the Alpa Ahar Vihara is taken. That's what I am telling now. Alpa Ahar Vihara is taken. As the classical procedure is given according to the Nasya, it is practiced. According to the classical procedure, as Nasya has been told, it is practiced.
Next question is from Dr. Neha. In hair fall condition, which oil is best for the Nasya?
Nasya, the Anutaila is best, and the Karpa Sastaila is the best Kafara and Vatahara Dravya it is used. Karpa Sastadi, apparently, in my view, the Anutaila and the Karpa Sastadi is best.
Next question is, which is the best time of day to use the Nasya? Next question is, which Anupan is used for Ekangavir Rasa and which Kashaya is used?
Ushna Jala, whichever I am using.
Do we have to prepare or Vishnu Tail is available in market? Sir has answered that contact. You can take the contact of sir from me after the session. Next question is, before Nasya Karma, if we go for Virechana?
No sir, we can't do the Virechana here because the facial paralysis are Ardhita affected person for a person where the Vata Dushti is there. Virechana is done in Pitta Dushti. In certainly conditions, in case of an Bell's palsy or in Ardhita Vata case, we should concentrate on those symptoms only. In other cases, we may do. And nowadays the pandemic is there and Nasya Karma is in every Ayurvedan prefers the Nasya Karma very well to prevent all the viral diseases like in the COVID and all. There is a most effective, the Nasya is very much effective nowadays. For a diet preventive purpose, for a preventive cure purpose, everyone may use the Nasya Karma.
So next question is, can we use Karna Puran for the explained case? Or Karna Abhyang to remove the vitiated dosha of Shira?
Maybe it may be helpful, but not done. The Karna Purana, the Karna Abhyanga, external Abhyanga is done. The Mukha Abhyanga, Mukha, the Karna comes in Mukha only. The external Abhyanga or the Bhaspa Sveta is done.
Anupan of Ekangarasa? In Bell's condition, is there any condition where Nasya should not be done?
There's a classical evidence. There is a classical reference. The Nasya is done. That has been given. execution of an essay is given, classically. That's not followed.
Sir, Brihat Vishnu Tel can be used for Nasya Karma.
Yes, may be used, but I am using the Alpa Vishnu Tel.
Next question is from Dr. Rakesh. What should be the duration of Nasya and internal medications in the chronic patient of Ardit?
It depends on the case, sir. But I am doing for 10 days. We may continue more than that also. If the affected part is lesser, we may get the results. Some of the cases, when the physiotherapy or the facial exercise, oftenly some of the cases do more, they will get the result more. Then we will minimize the, for 7 days we will do it. And moreover, I am practicing for 10 days. The essay which I am doing is for 10 days.
Next question is, will Vishnu Tel be beneficial in Ardit caused as a complication of stroke, ischemic stroke?
No, we cannot, it's a specific thing that only in the case of an Ardit Vat without any other effects, without any other diseases, without any contraindications, I am using. If at all, is there any complications with the multiple symptoms or the multiple diseases, we'll go accordingly with that.
Next question is again from Dr. Deepthi. Sir, to prevent Ekang Vat, what formulation should be done in case of Tel?
It goes on, it depends on the other bastis also used. It is mainly the whichever is all used. But the Vishnu Tel is the same one, Katravadravyas are there in present, it may be also used.
Is Nasya preferable for premature graying of hair?
Yes, completely it is used. It's very well indicated and result oriented also.
Sir, can we use this treatment for Pakshaghat?
Yes.
Okay, sir, we are done with the question sessions round, I think. And sir, okay. Thank you again for this wonderful representation of your case studies, your patient. It will be very helpful for us in our clinical practices. We are lucky enough to we get a chance to learning these concepts. Thank you so much, sir. Special thanks to IOTIP team, Dr. Deepak Mantri and Dr. Deepthi Patil. Without them, this was not possible for me to arrange this webinar with you. सो सर, हम आज हमारा सेकेंड डे कम्प्लीट हुआ है. उम्मीद करते हैं सर परसों 14th of October वी विल बी अगेन हेयर एट दिस 9 AM फॉर द डे 3. थैंक यू सो मच सर. थैंक यू सो मच.
थैंक यू फॉर ऑल द ऑर्गेनाइजर्स एंड ऑल द पार्टिसिपेंट्स व्हिच हैव मेड दिस वेबिनार सक्सेसफुल एंड आल्सो थैंक डॉक्टर जैन आल्सो एंड ऑल द कमिटीज एट ऑल द ऑर्गेनाइजर्स. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir.